Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy-to-understand whiteboard videos, and today I'll be sharing with you the difference between a proxy and a VPN. Along with this, I'll be answering some misconceptions about the famous debate of VPN versus proxy. So without any delay, let's get started. First, let's understand what is a proxy server. Well, a proxy server acts as a relay between the website you're visiting and your device. Your traffic goes through a middleman, which is a remote machine used to connect you to the host server, and the proxy server hides your original IP address so that the website sees the IP of the proxy. However, proxies only work on the application level, meaning it only reroutes the traffic coming from a single application you set your proxy up with. And also, they don't encrypt your traffic, meaning all your data is highly vulnerable while you're using a proxy. Moreover, there are three main types of proxy. Number 1, HTTP proxies. These are the ones which only cater to web pages. That means if you set up a browser with HTTP proxy, all your browser traffic will be rerouted through it. These are quite useful for web browsing and accessing geo-restricted websites. Number 2, SOX proxies. These proxies are not limited to web traffic, but still work on the application level. For example, you can set it up on a game, video streaming app, or a P2P platform. Although they can handle all kinds of traffic, they are usually slower than HTTP proxies because they are more popular and often have a higher load on them. Number 3. Transparent proxies. These are a different kind of proxy because their users are usually unaware of their existence. These proxies can be set up by employers or parents who want to monitor users' online activity and block access to specific websites. Hotels and cafes use them to authenticate users on public Wi-Fi, and companies or home users might also set them up to save bandwidth. Next, let's discuss what is a virtual private network. Just like proxy, a VPN also reroutes your internet traffic through a remote server and hides your IP address so websites can't see your original IP or location. However, it works on operating system level, meaning that it will redirect all your traffic, whether it's coming from browser or background app, to a new IP address. Further, a VPN also encrypts your traffic between the internet and your device. That means the internet service provider or ISP monitoring your internet activity and collecting data about you can no longer see what you're doing online, and would only see that you're just connected to a VPN server. The encryption in VPN also protects you from government surveillance, website tracking, and any snoopers or hackers who might try to intercept your device. In all, you can say that a VPN provides you with the ultimate online privacy and security measures. Further, it's important to note that both VPN and proxy providers can log user data such as IP address, DNS request, and other details. And as a user, you should avoid such providers because they can give this information to law enforcement agencies, advertisers, or hackers if their servers get breached. To keep your activity online truly private, look for a provider that has a strict no-log policy. Some of which I can recommend include ExpressVPN, NordVPN, and Surfshark. Next, here's a quick comparison between proxy versus VPN. Number 1. VPN encrypts your traffic while proxy servers don't. A VPN service provider protects you from ISP tracking, government surveillance, and hackers. Proxies don't, so they should never be used to handle sensitive information. VPNs work on operating system level and reroute all your traffic, while proxies work on the application level and only reroute the traffic of a specific app or a browser. VPNs can be slower than proxies as they need to encrypt your data. However, there are ways you can improve your connection and browsing speed with a VPN as well. VPNs are usually paid, and you should not trust free services as they have limitations and tend to mine your data, while many proxy servers are free to use. A VPN connection is more reliable, while a proxy server connection experiences drop more frequently. Next, let's answer some of the common questions that a VPN or a proxy user asks. First off, is a VPN better than a proxy? And my answer is, VPN is better as it provides privacy and security by rerouting your traffic through secure servers and encrypts your traffic in the process. Whereas a proxy simply passes your traffic through a mediating server, but doesn't necessarily offer an extra layer of protection. Moreover, unlike proxies, VPNs work on operating system level to secure all your traffic. Next, do you need proxy if you have a VPN? And the answer is no. Premium VPN services do the same thing as proxies and actually much more than that. You could use a proxy for a quick IP change, but do keep in mind that not all proxies are safe and some of them may collect your data as well. Next, can I use VPN and proxy together? And the answer is, VPNs and proxies can be used together, but this may take some work to do the configuration. I personally advise against it, as the proxy would simply add another middleman that slows down your connection without adding any significant benefits. Lastly, as a conclusion, I would like to say that a proxy and a VPN are similar because they both reroute your traffic to a remote server and hide your original IP address. However, a VPN is superior than a proxy in many aspects, and if you care about your privacy and security, you should without a doubt choose a VPN. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.